I promised you to show you a video about hip throws. There are literally thousands of hip throw instructionals out there on YouTube, either from Aikido or Judo or Jiu-Jitsu or whatever. So we don't want to put another hip throw video out there. The thing is, what I want to cover today is when do I do the hip throw? Because if I do the hip throw as an attack, so if I am here the overhook, here the underhook, I twist and I want to do the hip throw, so far the theory, the problem is, in the very moment when I turn my hip, he easily can bring me down. If he does it with me, the thing is, if he turns for the hip throw, his hips goes here, and his body twists, and all I have to do is to grab this shoulder on his body, and twist it in the other direction, stepping a little bit forward with his leg, and bring him down. Very, 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 very easy. But if you have the right timing, the most hip throws can be easily countered. So, but there is an occasion where they really, really make a lot of sense. In the very moment when he tries to attack me from the back, for example, to lift my body up and bring me down, oops, like that. So when he walks around, attacks my back, this is the moment to do the hip throw. So whenever he tries to step in the back, hip throw, this is the answer. And here, all three different kinds of hip throws I'm teaching come into play. If my arm is here, and he has already managed to grab around, I use what we call the shoulder throw. The shoulder throw, the shoulder has to be on the outside. If it's under, I never ever will hip throw him. Yeah? The idea is my shoulder is out and I throw over the hip. The next is, if I already managed overhook, underhook, and he is passing, here is the standard hip throw, or if he goes here, my head is over, and this. So hip throw makes sense if he steps into my back, and I have still an arm in.